for Utopia Parkway.
I'm gonna get my shit together. I will live my shit forever.
Utopia Parkway. We're Indy's damn best, as far as I know, only Fountains of Wayne tribute band. Yeah!
Number one!
We're here tonight to honor the life and music of Adam Schlesinger, principal songwriter and bass player for Fountains of Wayne, and he passed away due to complications from COVID last year. Are you okay?
Pull it back in.
You know, it's a Wednesday night show. We got the kinks to work on. But no, Adam passed away last year due to complications from COVID-19. And if history remembers him for anything, it'll be for Stacy's Mom, which is a great song and we'll get to later. But you know, Fountains of Wayne was more than just one song, and Adam Schlesinger was more than just one song. He wrote so many wonderful songs, not just for Fountains of Wayne, but for other bands like Ivy and Tinted Windows, and he wrote stuff for movies and TV shows and Broadway. I mean, the man literally could do it all. So we're gonna get to some of the things he did outside of Fountains of Wayne later, but for now we're gonna continue on with some Fountains of Wayne songs. This again, I don't know what's happening over there. Just play the electric, dude. Yeah, just play the electric. Yeah. Come on. Yeah. Woo! Electric guitar!
My music is back, baby!
Anyways. You almost made me shit myself twice. I'm trying to give a sentimental speech about a dead man. Anyway, this next song is from Fountains of Wayne's first record. It came out 25 years ago. I was in kindergarten. Holy shit. This song's called Barbara H.
Yeah!
Stop blaming it on a man you don't know.
It's Cole. Thanks for being here, Cole. This next song goes out to any guy who's ever done anything stupid to impress a lady. And then have Cole again. Yeah! You're my guy. So, this song's about a guy that goes and does something stupid to impress a girl, and it just backfires in his face, and he can't take it back because it's literally etched into his skin. It's called Red Dead Redemption 2. Ready, Jake? You know the band Bad Company? They had a record called Bad Company, and then on that record is a song called Bad Company. It's very meta and a very up your ass thing to do. We're gonna do that same thing here. We're Utopia Parkway, named after the Fountains of Wayne record, Utopia Parkway, and this next song is called Utopia Parkway. We're gonna let Billy Joel over here tickle the keys.
Keyboard.
One,
movie
stuff.
Yeah,
it's all right.
Stop.
Okay, two, three.
Well, I've been saving. Single they ever released back in 1996 called Radiation Vibe. Are you ready, Mr. Jake? I can't go unless Jake gives me that. He's got too many bells and whistles. He's trapped by the keyboard.
Jake, what's his name? He keeps saying, are you ready, Jake? What's his name?
Thank you.
Sir!
Job that you really fucking hated. Yeah! I mean, like, really fucking hated. You didn't, can't say that though. The children are the future, bro. He's a teacher. There was one job I had on the north side, like Keystone. I worked there for like 2 months. That's all I could stand.
What did you do? What was it?
It's boring. That's why it sucks. But this next song is one of my favorite songs that Adam ever wrote. It's on the first record. It's just about ordinary people trying to get through just another day, which is something that everyone in this room knows. This song's called Sick Day. Let Jake lead on this one.
piano in this one. There's the feet. There's the
no.
It's why we're all here.
No, it's not.
The joke that every keyboard is here.
We will never play that song.
Did anyone else see Fountains of Wayne live? When'd you see him?
Vogue in 2013.
I was there! Yeah. I was there, the Vogue in 2013. That's like the only time they ever came here.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the last tour they ever did.
I was so glad when I was
I was just like we didn't know it was the last tour at the time. We went going like, oh, it's cool, they're finally coming to India. And they just broke up. So it was like I think one of the five or six last shows they ever played.
Yeah.
But it's cool. It's a great show. I said earlier that, Adam wrote a lot of songs outside of Fountains of Wayne, and so we just thought it would be fitting to pay tribute to that part of Adam. So these next two songs are not Fountains of Wayne songs, but they are songs he wrote for other projects, in particular, two films about fictional bands. And I'm gonna sing like a woman on this next song. Who's seen Josie and the Pussycats? All the ladies. All the guys are like,
I've seen it. It's great.
No, it's great. But I can see some of the guys like, I'm gonna watch it with her. I was on my phone, like, checking, like, basketball score.
I don't think I can take it no more.
most famous song Adam ever wrote outside of Fountains of Wayne. He wrote it. He wrote it before he was even successful in Fountains of Wayne.
Yeah.
But are you ready? It's a little movie directed and starring Tom Hanks. It's about a band from Erie, Pennsylvania that become a bunch of one-hit wonders. So this is for Erie, Pennsylvania. This song is called, and the movie is called That Thing You Do. This sense of sadness and grief that I have. And it was in that moment that I wanted to do this show. And that was a year and a half ago. This literally has been a year and a half in the making. So thank you for being here. Thank you to HiFi for letting us play here. Thank you so much. And before I go any further, let me introduce you to the rest of the guys in the band real quick. On the drums! He spoils all of us. I don't ever want to play with another drummer ever again. Give it up for Mr. Matt Wilson. Here on bass, this kid, I've been playing songs with this guy for more than 10 years now. He grew up playing like hardcore punk bands. like the opposite of Fountains of Wayne. But he was still my first choice for a bass player, and so when I reached out to him, I was like, you want to play Fountains of Wayne? He's like, I only know Stacy's mom. And I was like, well, sure. But he said yes, and he's grown so much. Everything he's playing tonight is all the stuff that Adam wrote. He was a world-class musician. He's grown so much in the last couple months learning these songs. Give it up for Scott. I'm so proud of him. He's grown so much. And I've been playing music with this guy since we were in high school. We were children. He's doing all the bells and whistles tonight. There's so much that goes into even the most simple Fountains of Wayne songs, and they're deceptively tricky. He has to piece jumping back and forth between multiple instruments almost every song and singing all the high harmonies. Over here singing like a woman, but I love this band so much. This is Jacob Ludwig. And this is John. This band would not be possible without his sheer force of will and determination. This is the first song that I listened to after I found out that Adam passed away. It's my favorite Fountains of Wayne song. If you know, please sing along. This song's called Hackensack. Yeah. And I'm gonna try really hard not to cry while I sing this song, so. Still alive, and like it just guts me like a fish every goddamn time.
It's like the musical equivalent of like a Pixar movie. It's like, this is the part where the old lady dies.
Real men show emotion.
We all have that one person or multiple people that just get us through the day every day. Through all the bullshit, through all the tough stuff. There's always that. There's always that person you know that is always there to be your rock and your foundation with you. So
my wife.
Everyone up here besides me is married and or has kids, and I'm just living the rock and roll dream, playing Fountains of Wayne. So, you know what? This next song goes out to all the wives in the band and all the wives out there in the audience.
Thank you.
I know a bunch of you in this room know this song, so please help us sing along. Doing whatever it takes just to get back to someone that you love. It's called I-95, and it's about, you know, just going on a long distance and doing whatever it takes just to see someone that you love. When I was in middle school, my dad got laid off from his job, and there was one point where I was still living in Indianapolis, but he was driving 2.5 hours to Ohio just to keep food on the table. So this is for Dad.
Yeah.
bangers all the way out for the rest of the song.
Hey, real men cry. No glasses.
He's not wrong.
Real men cry.
Hey, the glasses are the sex appeal, man. What are you talking about?
I cried as if
like the sparkly pink flowers don't do it.
Where'd you get the shirt? Where from?
Macy's.
Macy's?
I will do a commercial for Macy's for free. If they
Macy's!
Keep
getting... I want it! Give it to me now!
This next song was the second Fountains of Wayne song I ever heard. The first one was Stacy's Mom, and this was back in the day when you had LimeWire. So as soon as I heard Stacy's Mom, I was like, that song fucking rules. What else did they do?
Yeah.
This was the next song I downloaded, and I immediately knew right away that Fountains of Wayne were not a joke band or a gimmick band, but they were a terrific band, and thus began my long journey of loving this band. So I played this song. So Scott used to do a thing called Breakfast, like a music festival, Breakfast, where people come over to his apartment and like play songs in the morning while he made like eggs and hash browns and shit. And he asked me to do it, and I played it, and I played this song, but I said I was going to do this Fountains of Wayne song. No, everyone was like, yeah, you can do Stacy's Mom. Then I didn't play Stacy's Mom, I played this song. And everyone looked at me like, what the hell? I love this song, I've always wanted to play with a band. This is like a dream come true for me, and this is my all-star career. I can play music with these guys until I die, so.
You do you!
This song's called Sacred Fire.
Songs.
Don't tell them that.
Adam. Who said you could talk?
Are they all three? No. None of them.
Are you still here?
Stacy bedtime.
Our set list a couple times before we did this show, and this next song is for this one man specifically.
Yeah!
His name is David Searle. He used to be a roadie for Reverend Peyton's Big Band Band.
Oh, yeah.
He and I used to do a podcast together about the Pacers several years ago called Another Time Podcast. Good friends with this man and his lovely wife, Jen. Like when I told him I was doing this show, he's like, are you gonna play Leave the Biker? It's like, I mean, I don't know.
You have to!
I know, now we are, so. It's called Leave the Biker.
Woohoo!
Throw the gun.
Scotty's mom.
Got him.
And everyone laughed, and it was a great day.
And then I forgot the chords halfway through. But I did forget the chords halfway through because I played this song like 100,000 times in the last year and a half. Without further ado, we give you Stacy's mom.
Well, you're all here.
I better hear all of you sing along to this song.
Thank you.
everyone for coming out tonight.
We have one more song. Thank you so much again. Thanks to the HiFi, thanks to Sun King for putting this on. Thanks to Chris, the awesome badass sound out there. Thanks again to Matt and Jake and Scott for wanting to do this with me.
No problem. Bro.
So, this next song is a cover of a cover. The Kinks originally wrote it, and then Fountains of Wayne did it. And Fountains of Wayne were the first band to perform on Conan O'Brien after 9/11, and they performed this song. And it was such a fitting message then. It's about trying to find good things in impossibly difficult circumstances, which was so fitting after 9/11. It feels so true right now, given everything that's going on in the world. So we're going to send you home with a thank you and a hope for good days to come. The song is called Better Things.
This is the last song. We'll just hold it again. shit out of your shit.
Especially with the pandemic. I hope you took care of it.
For making them sit through this song again.
Thank you so much. That was wonderful.